right, ladies and gentlemen, y'all already know what time it is, man. If you like the video, subscribe for more daily 2K content, and let's get right into it. NBA 2K21. We know we're in the midst of a zendemic. We know that people are out there, they cheating, and they loud and proud with it, man. We understand that 2K is doing some things. They're taking some steps to try to combat it. But the steps are, I feel like these steps are invalid. They're not going to work. And I'm going to tell you why right after this. So if you don't do anything else, make sure y'all like the video, subscribe for more daily 2K content. We're dropping the 2K heat every day of the week. This channel is committed to helping you guys get better, giving you the news, and showing you the nuances in the game that's going to help you beat other people by the margins. So it's a good channel to be subscribed to. And without further ado, let's get right into it.
If you make it to C25, that's OG status. I was told you could be anything, just don't be average. Down bad, flat pockets, that shit made me a savage. Start hustling nonstop, don't plan on breaking that habit.
All right, so for the chases on the case, people, we got the anti-Zen question. Imagine doing this and you're using a Zen. Bro, I don't have no Zen. Wish I did, though. I ain't gonna cap to you because there's some things you can do with it that outside of cheating at the game that make it useful. But yeah, this is not a sensational day for me. Not even gonna lie to you. Look, man, this is what I wanna show y'all, bro. This is something that's getting on my nerves. 2K keeps making changes to the shot stick. You've been trying to shoot the other day and you can't really shoot, and you've been shooting shot stick no meter. This is why. Because they made it, they once again have made this joint be random. Not only that, but the green zone is tighter than ever. And when I'm talking about the green zone is tighter than ever, it's almost non-existent. Now, I don't know what made them do this or why they felt like they needed to, but it just is one of those things that has happened and we got to deal with it. I can understand it because, you know, you probably got people shooting with the meter on and some people with the meter off trying to hide the fact that they're cheating. And so if they shrink down the green zone and make it so only a robot can hit it every time, because that's all they can hit it. Like, I used to be able to hit it maybe two out of three times. Now only, I feel like, I don't know, let me know if I'm just trash, but I feel like only a robot can hit it consistently now. So if you see somebody just greening with the shot stick, bro, I don't know. If it's just catch and shoot, maybe, but bro, I can't do it anymore. And I'm trying to take this little feedback. And let me show you something real quick, man, because this is what I'm saying. Like, look, boom, I'm pulling it straight down. That's green, right? So that's straight down. I didn't change anything. Now it's slightly left. Didn't change anything. I'm still holding the same spot. Now it's slightly right. So look, it's just now it's slightly left, holding it in the exact same spot, slightly left. Like what's going on with that? I'm not getting it. I do understand that they said that they made a little, now we're gonna do it again. I do understand that they said they made a little adjustment. So if you're holding the shot stick down before, with the meter on, if you're holding it down before, it's gonna be random. But bro, this is beyond random. It's the same thing, and it's slightly left, slightly right, and it was green a second ago. And I would agree with everything that they're doing, but, and I would think that I just suck, because maybe I do just suck. But the problem is this. Watch. We're going to come over here, turn this up to superstar. Obviously, I'm going to miss some because we're on superstar, right? Turn the shot meter on. Do the exact same thing, and I just don't understand why I feel like I cannot find that zone with that, but with this, I'm gonna do it with damn near, 80% accuracy. You see how close that was? I'm gonna probably be doing it with about 80% accuracy once I get going. And this is on superstar. Look at that, boom. This is on superstar. So it's like, obviously it's gonna be a little bit more difficult. That's gonna miss because it was that's one of those denied greens, is what we call those. They straight deny you a green because that's one of the other things that they're doing to combat the stick. If you're right on it and it doesn't turn green, you're gonna miss the shot 100% of the time. So if it's right on it and you don't get perfect timing, you're gonna miss the shot 100% of the time. You see what I'm doing right here? I am hitting this. I know, what this is proving to you is I know where the green zone is. And once I find it, I could make these shots with a whole lot of accuracy. That is right. But the point is that I'm not trash. I can find the spot, and once I know where it is and I got a mental note of it, I can hit it a whole lot of the time. Look at that. I'm hitting it almost every time. And they moved this again because at first it was straight down. You had to pull it straight down, and now you got to pull it straight down and a little to the right. But look, you see me hit all these greens in a row. This is on Superstar, right? This is on, they're going to miss. Stop! Y'all got to come up with a better solution. But look, they're going to make me miss that one too. Bro, what is this? I'm centering it, and you just won't let it turn green. Do you understand how frustrating this is? I worked so hard to get good at this, and all y'all want to do is make it so that's dead. That's gonna be. And all y'all want to do is make it so it's just harder. I get it. They're gonna make me miss that one too. And it's perfectly centered. But y'all get the point of what I'm trying to say, bro. I can center this thing at a very high clip on meter on. But with meter off, I'm doing the exact same thing, trying to find a location. I know that there are two different locations. There are two different zones, right? But it's just not letting me do it. But that's how I surmise what they're trying to do is trying to root out the people that are cheating. But you're only making the game harder for people that are playing the game, honestly, because what we're going to do is we're going to hop into this gameplay. You're only making the game harder for the people that are playing the game, honestly, because I'm out here busting my tail trying to help people get better with the shot stick, getting people to use the shot stick, doing all of that stuff. I'm saying, hey, use the shot stick. It's the way. You get two chances at a green. It's less randomness. And you know, you got to be good. You got to be good to do it. You got to do some practice, but you will be able to do it. Keep this dude, Emac, in your head, man. But you got to be better in order to do it. But now, it is literally damn near impossible to center it every time. Now, you can still get your excellent time, and that's cool. But unless you're a robot or you got a script, and you see somebody out there doing that, look at this dude, take the shot. Nothing. Slightly right. Right? Keep that in mind. It's slightly right because he took a fading shot and there was somebody in his face. But look, Dre shooting with the button, slightly late. You know, he still get the green animation. It's not green, but it's green. It's just one of those where they just kill you. Keep in mind, I was centering that joint at a higher difficulty as well, right? The thing that I'm trying to point out to y'all is, I get what they're trying to do as far as this. Look at this. A centered layup? We centering layups right now? The thing that I'm trying to point out to you guys is that they're just trying to root out cheating because they feel like, now look, I'm trying to figure out what he wanted to do. I got some hesitation in my shot. Why? Because I used the shot stick, and I know that there's a little delay when you use the shot stick. You saw how he took those first two shots with no hesitation or whatever? Look at Dre. He had to go behind somebody. The point I'm trying to make is what 2K likes to do is they're trying to fix the problem, and I commend y'all for trying to fix the problem, but this ain't the way. Y'all need to get with somebody like me. I understand that this thing has been in the community for years. I understand how it works. I can tell you what you need to do in order to fix it. Because the 2K community, I'm going to tell you in this video, the 2K community only does things that are 100%. So if it don't work every time, they're not interested in it because they can lose the game off of it. So they're not going to be interested in it. All you need to do is move like... You gotta move the green zone. You can't not move the green zone. You're just shrinking the green zone and you're making it be a random size. But the middle of the green zone is consistent. You can't do that. You have to move it. Even if it's one tick, 1 degree. Look at that, he just took that shot right there. Nobody takes that shot with the shot stick because you know you can't really get it off because you can't load it up fast enough center. But that's fine. He might just be better than me. Right there, when I saw it, I said, oh yeah, he's cheating. But really what y'all have done is made it so that only people that are cheating can use shot meter off and green reliably. And maybe that's what y'all wanted. So if you can't see the stick moving or something like that, you'd be like, people don't got nothing to lose. But the reason that I use shot meter off is because I don't want to get the penalty for not pulling the stick down fast enough. If you can make that joint be to the right every single time, and I can make it be to the right every time in a way other than speed, look at him. He's just taking the shot just straight, just catching it. I'm just centering. I'm raw. And I get it, though. You see how we made him miss the first shot? And it didn't matter. Now I'm leaving him open. I'm literally saying in the video, you know what? I want to leave him open so we can see if he hits these. We denied him the ball in the first place. It doesn't matter if he's cheating because he sucks. The dude sucks. Like, y'all out there calling Zen every time y'all lose a game, but not everybody that you play against is using the Zen. Some of y'all just suck. and you're just not good at the game, and you need to just admit that. This dude is leaving me wide open. This is how I know he ain't. That's how I know he using the Zen. Why are you leaving the stretch five wide open? You can buy the Zen, you can't buy IQ. So you can buy skill, quote unquote, but you can't buy IQ, of which he has none. Leave him open again. Look at this. Take the shot. He's just centering. Wide open. I'm not mad at that. He wide open. He should hit the shot. That's how I feel. I'm leaving him open so that he will take these shots. I want him to take the shots. I'm inviting him to take the shot. But like I said, maybe he's just better than everybody else. But effectively, what you all have done, 2K, is made it so only people that are cheating are able to use that version of the shot stick. When people that are not cheating, we want to be able to use that version of the shot stick too, because I know where the center is, I can hit it reliably, and I want to be able to shoot the ball without having to deal with that penalty with it sliding. Because 20% of my misses, maybe 50% of my misses come from guessing wrong. I thought I snatched it down fast enough, and I didn't snatch it down fast enough, and it also put some hesitation in my shot. I don't want that hesitation in my shot. I want the freedom to just fire. I want to fire that gas. Like I told y'all, it don't matter what Mike do. He can change shooting as much as he want to. I'm still going to fire that gas. It don't matter what he do. If he changes it anymore, nobody going to be able to shoot. And guess what? I'm going to be the only one out there firing gas. So if you want everybody using the Zen, Mike, keep changing it. Keep on changing it. Because I don't care. Do whatever you got to do. I'm going to fire that gas. And I'm going to hit it. I'm just like LeBron. You LeBron, I'm Bronny. And you can't stop me from firing that gas. Maybe that's a bad joke. But anyway, check this out. This is what I wanted y'all to see right here, man. Look, we're going to go backwards, right? This is what I want y'all to see. We're going to go backwards, and we're going to look at the young boy's stats, right? And when we're looking at his stats, I know stats don't tell the whole story, but somebody like that, what would you expect him to be shooting? You know, you would expect him to have, like, high 90s stats and be shooting maybe, you know what I'm saying? What would you expect him to be shooting like? 61%, 50% at least. Look at this. This dude got an 80 mid-range and a 78 three ball. And he firing gas with no conscience. Who you know, by gas, you got guards in the comp stage that's corner sitters with higher stats that don't fire gas like that. Let's go ahead and take a look. We gonna take a look. First thing we're gonna do is this. NBA, 34%. You shooting 34% in the NBA, but you just shot 75% out here in the park. You're only mustering a 50 win percentage in the NBA, but you find gas in the park though. It's a 50%. Y'all can't see it, but look, y'all want me to take the camera down so y'all can see it. Hold on, man, cam, boom. Look at that, 50%. 50% in the park. What do we got? 48% in the park, 28 win percentage. But you find gas like that, 43% from the field. How you shoot lower from the field? Hey, I guess, man. Look, this is all I'm trying to say. People gonna cheat. There's a way to stop people that cheating. Most of the time, the people that are cheating, they're just not good at the game. But if somebody's centering that joint over and over right now, like a couple weeks ago, me, Gambit, Dre, everybody, we were centering that joint over and over. Somebody centering it over and over now, as random as this joint is, something's going on, man. Look at this, man. This dude is a shooting guard. I don't even know what build this is. He's a slasher. And he firing gas like that with no fear? I get it. I see some slashers out there doing it. And, you know, he'll be at an 80-some-odd three when he gets there. But look, though, this is the whole point I'm trying to make. Like I said, look at him and look at the park. Look at the park stats. Stats don't tell the whole story every time, but I think that you guys are intelligent enough to know that the stats in this case are telling the story. 34%. In the NBA. What's this? Look at this. Look at catching. Look at his bat. I mean, he got flexible release for what? You centering everything. Why you doing that? Corner specialist? He don't even got on the badges right. He got on silver range extender. Bro, you need that gold more than anything. But that's cool though. I ain't worried about that. He got intimidated in clamps. He got some of those joints on. Look, bro, this bad setup is a mess. Look at this. 2K Beach. Check it out. So in the rec. Boom, 32%, 25% win percentage. But look, though, you can tell what he did, right? When he got that Zen, this is what he did. 48% from the 2K Beach. What up? But he got that Zen. I think it showed the 3-on-3 pro-am. I showed one with 3-on-3 pro-am. He was like, he had played like 2 or 3 games in 3-on-3 pro-am, and he was fine gas and that. Not even gonna lie, percentages were higher in there than anywhere else. How is that? 3-on-3 pro-am, if any of y'all played that, y'all already know how hard it is to shoot in there. But I ain't trying to keep y'all forever, man, because look, check this out, bro. This is what I want y'all to see. This is what a shooter looked like. I got an 89 three ball. This is what I shoot in the NBA. I'm shooting almost 80% in the NBA with 100% win percentage, 27 games. Like, come on, man. 78 from three, 66 in the park. And I can't center that joint, 68. Maybe he just had a lucky game. Maybe that's what y'all gonna say. Maybe this, maybe that wreck 58%, 91 win percentage in there. 3-on-3 pro-am, 55%. Look, it's significantly harder to shoot in there to me than anywhere else. I'm shooting better in the wreck than in there. We ain't playing no five. But the whole point I'm trying to make is, I think y'all understand, 2K is going about fighting this problem the wrong way. You got to move the actual green zone. You can't make it skinny. You can't put it differently for two different places. You got to move it so like somebody like me, I can perceive it, but I can't really perceive it. All you got to do is just move it one little degree here and there, and then this is what you'll get. I can adjust to it, and I can figure it out, and I can do all of this stuff. Somebody using the script, they won't be able to. You don't have to make it be like, you see what I'm saying? Like I can adjust to that. It don't have to be random like that. Now I gotta get back into the groove, right? It don't have to be random the way that y'all are doing it. Just do it like this. You see how it's coming up randomly right here? Not randomly, but I'm not hitting it. If you just made it move a little bit and I gotta chase it or whatever, at least it won't be a guaranteed shot. Like that, I'm trying to make it move, but you can't make it move. So look, you see how that is? Like, don't just make people miss shots that they should be hitting. You should use the solution is, the solution really is just move this black zone a couple of millimeters every time. I can chase to that. I can move to it, but the machine would not be able to adjust to it. And then just make pulling the trigger mandatory. That's it. Like, there is a script out there that has people with excellent. I get it. But if you're moving one of them, at least it won't be so blatant or something, man. I don't know, man. It is what it is. They get excellent. They got a hell of a script and they got better programs. Y'all probably need to hire some of them. I know y'all guys work hard on this, and this is the least of y'all worry, but bro, I'm tired of people accusing me of cheating when all I've done is work hard to learn how to use this joint, and everybody else just cheating out there, man. It's not cool. Like I said, that kid was clearly cheating. He just got his Zen today. It probably just came in the mail, and he like, yes! Yes, damn it! This is sensational! That's probably what he was like, but it is what it is. Like I said, a human can adjust the stick reliably. The robot case. That's all I want to say, man. Move it a couple of millimeters or just a half a degree or anything, and then they'll start missing, they'll stop using it. Only reason they're using it because it's 100% right now. And like I said in the video, when I first saw it, I said, whew, people gonna be cheap. And stop making me miss these perfectly centered ones, man. Stop punishing me. I'm doing what I'm supposed to do. Anyway, I'm gonna holler at y'all. Till next time. It's your boy Jay Easy, aka Fresh from the Barbershop, BK and the People's Champ. Godspeed, man. Y'all take it easy. Leave a like on the video if you made it this far. Give me a gem star if you made it this far, and I'm going to holler back. Peace. Commits. It don't make cash and it don't make sense, cause we can't pay rent with no one's opinion. So in that sense, I never value your 2 cents. Hey, darn, please leave that bullshit you speak at the barn, cause I ain't buying. I'm only 5'8", that's fine, nigga. I can give a heart transplant to a giant. I ain't lying. Godspeed. We good.